We're going to play a little make or break here. The one factor that you guys think could make or break each team's season. Let's start with Illinois, Coach.
You know, there's not a lot of things that are simple about this game, but playing hard is something that's simple. And this is what make or breaks Illinois' season coming up. We talked about smooth transitions at Wisconsin and Purdue this year. This was a tough transition for Tim Beckman a year ago. And that's okay the first year. One of the reasons you knew it was a tough transition, they didn't look like they played hard every game. This year, it's a must. Second year, you've got to get your message across, Howard. To me, make or break for Illinois, play hard every single game.
Yeah, going out and giving maximum effort gives you an opportunity to win football games, and I think that's what they have to do.
And they also have to stop making mistakes. I mean, they shot themselves in the foot last year, 23 straight games with at least one turnover. That is the fifth longest streak right now in the entire nation. Indiana, Howard.
Well, for Indiana, I think it's simple. They have to get off the football field from a defensive standpoint. A traditional offense maybe needs 69, 70, maybe 71 plays to win the football game, and I'm talking about their opponents. Their opponents got 79 plays each and every time they played Indiana. That's way too much. They have to be able to get off the football field. They have to be able to excel in third down situations as well.
You know, when you talk about play numbers, too, the Indiana offense can probably help the defense some. They don't have to always go up tempo, and I think Kevin Wilson had changed the tempo up a little bit last year. He may do it more this year.
It would help to give up fewer yards in those plays, too. 213 plays of 10 or more yards last season.
And 6 yards a play.
Yeah, 6 yards a play. That's not going to win you a lot of games. So that was the issue for Indiana. Clearly, defense just has to be better. Purdue.
Embrace the new style of offense. John Shoup, the offensive coordinator, has put in the traditional West Coast offense. It's a downhill attack. A few years back, Purdue ran a similar offense, but most recently they've been running the spread. So you've got to change gears as an offensive lineman. You need to be dominant at tailback. We've already talked about Rob Henry, a quarterback. He's got to organize the whole thing. He's got to get them in the right place. They've got to convert to this new offense.
Making sure they're in the right place, because one thing that West Coast offense does provide you, if you see a bad play from an offensive standpoint, you usually have the ability to change the play and maybe go to a different one that gives you a better opportunity to make some plays and also find those tight ends.
Speaking of finding tight ends, Penn State has some awfully good ones. What makes or breaks the season for the Nittany Lions?
I think ultimately really comes down to health once again this year. When you think about the way Bill O'Brien practices, we watch it, you're not going to see guys going to the ground. So he's getting them prepared for Saturdays each and every day. They practice at a very high tempo. But again, they have to be able to stay healthy so that they can perform on game day.
And Bill has great experience from the NFL small rosters to Penn State small roster a year ago. Plus, he is an intense football coach, and they don't have to bring each other to the ground to be intense during practice. He'll make them be intense.
Ohio State.
Well, they have to improve on defense. I don't think we've talked about this. They may have lost some guys last year. I don't think we've talked about that.
They're young and talented.
I don't think we've talked about that either. For goodness sakes, let's just see if they do it. I mean, they've got to get better on defense, right? They have to be national championship-style defense if they want to win a national championship.
Yeah, and you know what? I'd throw one other area in as well. Special teams. They have to continue to be dominant in that area. And something historically they really have in control. But with all the talent that they have, they should have a super special teams unit.
And it'd be nice to have a 1,000-yard tailback, too, although Urban Meyer's won two national championships without having one.
Without one, but with a great defense.
No doubt.
Without either, I would suggest it'll be difficult without either.
No doubt. Very fair point. Wisconsin.
It's about protecting the quarterback. Stave has to be able to stand tall in the pocket. Some of those sacks, 28 of them, I think you could attribute to the quarterback in some situations. Maybe holding on to the ball too long, not just going with his first or second read. But he's developed from that. He's had a chance to watch the game. I'm sure he'll say after the weekend that the game's kind of slowed down a little bit for me. And I think that's one of the things that happens to second-year players.
You know, Andy Lugwood, the offensive coordinator, he obviously knows protection is an issue. It's been an issue at Wisconsin the last 3, 4, 5 years, because every time we've gone there, both times we've gone there, they've worked the heck out of pass protection, especially play-action protection.
Need a little help in the secondary, too. That's an inexperienced group, so if that group can come together, that will certainly help them defensively.